Look up the word crazy in the dictionary and you might just find an asterisk beside the definition that says, listen to the Subiquitous Podcast featuring Sue Duffield and you'll find out what crazy means. Sue's travelogue journey of unfiltered stories, impossible miracles, and faith-filled fun will be revisited right here. So buckle up and let's get going with this humorous travelogue of an unfiltered saint, Subiquitous.
Marilyn McCoo and Billy Davis Jr.'s number one crossover hit of the 70s on both the Billboard Hot 100 and Hot Soul singles, when dissected, could possibly be the best lyrical teaching tool for all Christian artists desiring that little word called notoriety. You know, I used to listen to this song and wonder, does anyone really get what they're singing about? Well, first of all, the voice of Marilyn McCoo is an inspiration to me. It always has been. It always will be. A velvet, soulful smoothie she is. And to know that her witness for Christ is just as real makes me love her even more. A true star inside and out, I understand. So in lies the paradox of this song. McCoo and Davis are real stars singing about how not to be a star. It's very curious. Baby, come as you are with just your heart, and I'll take you in. You're rejected and hurt. To me, you're worth what you have within. Whew. You know, I'm emotional just reading that. And some of you 70s leftovers like me probably sing it without even looking at the lyric. But seriously, read them again. What do you see? For the performer in us who just can't wait to be noticed, Jesus strongly urges us to come as we are. He takes us in. We're rejected, hurt, filled with jealousy, envy, and even succumbing to that comparison factor. But to Him, we are worth what we have within. I especially love this line because nowhere is it stated in this pop hit, you're worth what you have because what's on the outside. So why do we work so hard on everything exterior, yet leave our insides deplete of maturity and spiritual hunger? By the way, spiritual hunger is a good thing. And if you don't have that hunger, you need it. It's another paradox. To lack having spiritual lack means you don't need Jesus. And the answer comes next. Now I don't need no superstar, right? There it is. That's when most of us will tune out, quit reading this post, or quit hearing this episode and moving on. We're enamored and impressed with everything runway, pizzazzy, glitzy, glossy, and viral. What do you mean Jesus doesn't need a superstar to represent Him? Isn't that what this whole aspiration of getting known is all about? To make Jesus be lifted up? The more well-known I become, the more people know me, the more I can do so much more for Him, right? That's what we think. If I could only be famous on TikTok. A few years ago, a very special friend of mine gripped my heart when he spoke from the platform. He said this. Very open, very vulnerable, and very forgiven. He said, too many of us leave church services wanting to be empowered or to be lifted up. I'm saying, let's leave empowering Jesus and lift Him up. Way to go, Josh. You know, this is a constant battle. We want to be elevated. We want to be empowered. We need more of Jesus. We need to be lifted up. I find little of that in Scripture. In fact, John 3, verse 30 says, He must become greater, and I must become less. So the lyric in the song says, you won't be denied because I'm satisfied with the love that you can inspire. I won't be denied. Awesome. An inspiring love brings satisfaction? You mean you want me to just love you and not be a star? Yes, I'm pretty sure that's what Christ is asking of us. Just love him and don't be all starry about it. Because sooner or later, somebody nobody knows could steal the tune that you want to hear. So stop your running around, because you found what was cloudy and clear. There'll be no cheering from the crowd, just two hearts beating out loud. There'll be no parades, no TV or stage, only me till your dying day. Well, I'm not Marilyn McCoo, but I will say this. Priceless, precise lyrics in that song. And years ago when I worked for Oldies Radio, I had a few listeners tell me they found Jesus. Are you ready for this one? They saw the light of Christ when they heard this song. Imagine that. I had one gal actually tell me it was the Holy Spirit that spoke very clearly to her while listening to a Peggy Lee's dismal, disparaging hit called Is That All There Is? She said it so gripped her about her own lack that she had to do something about it. You don't have to be a star to be in his show. In fact, I'd advise you not to be. Don't think your star has to shine for me to find out where you're coming from. What is a beauty queen if it don't mean I'm your number one? Burma shave. There you go. If I have to explain the whole Burma shave meaning, well, forget that. And then the song ends and it says this, and I quote, "And I don't need no superstar, 'cause I'll accept you as you are. You won't be denied because I'm satisfied with the love you can inspire." So here's my starstruck prevention list. Number one, inspire others to love the superstar. Number two, be less so Jesus can be more. And number three, create an attitude and atmosphere that never questions your motives. Number four, be more concerned what God thinks about you than what others think about you. 'Cause, quote, you don't have to be a star, baby, to be in my show. This reminder, baby, is for all of us. God knows that we are full of ourselves. We want attention, we want affection, and we want it our way. And the star qualities abound, but none of that behavior or mindset works in his show. You don't have to be that, baby. You don't have to ever do that. This post was inspired while driving with my daughter back in 2013 in a rental car. I accidentally pressed the OnStar button several times, getting an operator who very harshly said to me, "Don't ever do that again." So I say all that to say this. I hope you have UNStar. This is the Subiquitous Podcast for 2023. We thank you for being a part of this wonderful outreach. Once again, get on SueDuffield.com. And I promise this, we have some special giveaways coming up in the month of February. You're really going to need to listen. And we can't wait to give away some of the stuff that we have. So stay tuned. We love you, and we'll see you next week.